Welcome to Lunch Bag. I'm Rallin Simmons Allen, coming to you from the Northern Caribbean University studio in Mandeville, Jamaica. With me are my incredible co-hosts, Chris Ann Hewitt, Chanel Mills, and Tyreek Smith.
Thanks for joining us again. Each week, the show gets better and better, and today promises to be another great one.
That's right, Chanel. And I just want to talk about 2020. 2020 has been an unforgettable year.
That is true.
Am I right?
For sure.
Definitely. And which word would you use to describe 2020?
I would use the word different. Different meaning we've had to adjust to so many different changes, and each memory that we have of 2020, whether we want to accept it or not, Rana and Tyreek, they've helped us to be who we are today.
Definitely.
My word is monumental, because a lot of the changes that we have had are historic, and 2020 is going to be remembered for all these incredible occurrences. So I'm working with monumental.
Definitely. And for me, I would say We are having a very catastrophic year thus far. And reason being, every month we have something coming our way.
Something unexpected.
That's right.
Yeah.
And, you know, 2020 has been just, you know,
we just can't find the words at this point. But let us talk about the role of technology in our lives, especially in the year 2020, when everything that we do right now is virtual.
Definitely.
What about that?
We have seen where pretty much every aspect of our lives has, I could say, risen to the occasion.
That's true.
In that, you know, school is pretty much fully online. Lots of businesses have had to get to that place.
Yes.
Yeah.
And whether we were ready for it or not, we are there.
We're adjusting.
And you spoke about businesses, because more than ever, now businesses are more striving, because, you know, they are more... They are putting out their products, they are out there online, they are using different social media platforms to promote their businesses, and they are getting...
And just to add to what you're saying, Tyreek, a lot of businesses that weren't comfortable with online marketing before, it's the norm now, so that's what everybody has to be doing. And let's also talk about Trinidad going virtual. You guys remember the first show when we spoke about Antigua and Barbuda having their virtual vacation? Well, Trinidad is spicing it up over there with something similar. How do you guys feel about that?
And... You know, I would really want to see what Trinidad has to offer.
Yeah.
You know, because I have never heard of someone going to Trinidad for a vacation.
That's it.
You know, so I really would want to see what Trinidad have to offer.
That's true. I've never heard about, like, somebody never say it. You know, someone go to Trinidad.
Yes.
I've never really heard that.
You know, otherwise some maybe carnival or things like that. But
or what we've seen.
Well, carnival is it. When you think about it, each island nation is noted for something.
That's it. That's
so
true.
You mentioned it right there, carnival. But I'm thinking then, if Trinidad is, as it were, following suit, perhaps it is the new direction for all destinations, especially Caribbean destinations, you know, to be looking in that direction. So who knows, maybe Jamaica is going to be trying that next.
Maybe very soon, because Tourism Trinidad Limited launched a new destination marketing website on Monday, November 30.
That's right. This website aims to encourage its users to visit the island via 360 virtual tours. The website also promises to have a calendar of events, an exciting tour package, and a COVID-19 resource that will provide real-time information as well as traveling restrictions.
The website will be a one-stop point to guide tourists making travel plans to the midst of the pandemic. What do you guys think about that?
Well, we need to be safe.
Yeah.
Yes.
And when you think about it, life is happening more at home. Not necessarily home life, but life is happening more at home.
All entirely at home.
And you don't want to be stuck in your home, that one place where you should be safe.
That's
so
true.
I think this is an excellent way to make sure that you don't get tired of this place that you cannot leave.
Definitely.
I'm really looking forward to diving into today's menu, however. But first, let us talk about what's happening in the news lately.
And that's right, Chanel. Now it's time for our island chat.
Expresses appreciation for Diego Maradona, the former Argentine football player who was regarded as one of the greatest players of all time, we too at Lunchbag extend our tribute. Take a look.
90 minutes,
90 minutes of sweat. 90 minutes of pain. It all comes down to these 90 minutes. When you step out on that field, you're spending 90 minutes. 90 minutes that will never come back. These 90 minutes can determine your future. They can change your whole life if you use them correctly.
Oh, kind of Heavenly Father, we are sensible men, we are responsible men, and we look out for each other. Please help us to show that in the game that we're about to play. Help us to be responsible people as we have fun, oh God. In your name we pray. Amen.
The aim of the game is to compile a tribute file. Yeah, man. One person has gone. So we just do a tribute file. There's no referee.
Yeah.
So we are gonna just abide by them. The file is going to be on the internet. And as the universe is here, yeah, going on and then right, someone them. Yes, there's someone in my soap. There's someone in my soap. No, everybody knows the idea. Just do this as a tribute to my
You know, as we come to the end of this phase of our life, we find ourselves trying to remember the good times.
I'm sure I'll have to go chair at the moment.
And the bad times.
Diego Maradona, widely regarded to be one of the greatest footballers to ever play the game, has died. In a statement from the Argentine Football Association, through its president, Claudio Tapia, expresses its deepest sorrow for the death of our legend, Diego Armando Maradona.
Awesome. So our video was in part courtesy of the Excelsior Club of NCU. What news caught your eye, Chanel?
Well, one news in particular that has been buzzing all over my social media is a new curfew hours as the holiday approaches. And right now I stumbled saying the new curfew hours because seeing it alone just, ugh. You know what I'm saying? Reading it and seeing it, I am stressed out about it. How do you feel?
You're feeling restricted already.
Restricted already. On November 24th, Prime Minister Andrew Honus shared with Cyril, he shared that starting December 1st, still startled, Ronald, now see with me, shared starting December 1st, 2020, the curfew will begin at 10 p.m. and end at 5 a.m. the following day.
All right, so on Christmas Day and Boxing Day, the curfew will begin at 7 p.m. and end at 5 a.m. the following day. However, after Boxing Day, the curfew will revert to beginning at 10 p.m. from December 27 to December 31st on New Year's Eve.
All right, and on New Year's Day, the curfew will begin at 7 p.m. and end at 5 a.m. the following day. After the holiday, the curfew time will begin at 10 p.m.
And you know, Rana, I've already hear people talking about breaching the curfew. You know?
I'm not the only one, Tariq, who's hurt.
Oh, my
yes, God. So, guys, please stay inside, obey what the Prime Minister has put in store in place for you, for your safety, mm-hmm. and for my safety. Yeah. Thanks.
All right, so Terry, what news item caught your attention?
Right, so what news item caught my attention is the five-year-old mm-hmm. that was bitten by a dog. You know, so the five-year-old dog bit victim in recovery Mikkel Allen was viciously attacked by a pack of dogs in his hometown of St. Dacre, St. Anne.
You know, the extent of Mikkel's damages are severe. 50 to 60% of his scalp was torn away, almost to his forehead, his left ear, and a part of his left cheek. And his arms and legs were also injured.
And despite the horror, Mikkel received a beacon of hope when Dr. Garfane, the chief of plastic surgery at the Montefiore Children's Hospital, heard about what happened to Mikkel, and he was so moved that he helped and managed to raise $250,000 in donations for Mikkel's healthcare.
Yes, Tariq. Now Mikkel is making a speedy recovery at home. The doctor even said that he's sitting up, eating, talking, and playing with his toys.
Awesome stuff.
It's truly great that Mikkel was able to get some financial help. Get well, Mikkel. Let's talk some more about finance in Money Matters.
Hello, my name is Robert Davis and welcome to Money Matters. Did you know that approximately $600 billion was spent during the Christmas season of 2019? Studies done by American philanthropist Joshua Baker shows that individuals spend 9 times the amount they usually do when retail shopping for Christmas. This is not only in America, but this is a worldwide phenomenon where individuals spend exorbitant amounts of money during the festive season. If you are a low spender, I implore you, take note of what I'm about to mention. During Christmas, many persons look at how they can spend some extra money. But not many persons look at how they can take advantage of Christmas and make some extra money. The secret to making extra money during the Christmas time is very simple. All you have to do is look at what is in demand. Whatever is in demand, you position yourself in a place to supply that demand. For example, Christmas cakes are in high demand during the festive season. If you are able to bake or you know someone who is able to bake, you can create a small pop-up business that sells Christmas cakes. By doing this, you are putting yourself in a position to supply the great demand for Christmas cakes during the season. That is just a small example, but look at what is around you and see what is in demand and position yourself in a place to supply that demand. According to the Bank of Jamaica, retail transactions are slowly shifting from physical currency to electronic means, with increased traffic to internet-based credit card transactions. With this information, we can see that more and more individuals are shopping online, and this provides a very unique opportunity for someone from anywhere in the world to set up a business on sites such as Amazon, Etsy, or eBay and make a profit. Black Friday is no longer a physical event, and all that traffic has now been diverted online. So if you have a store on the sites mentioned before, there is opportunities for you to make a lot of profit. As I mentioned before, the great thing about e-commerce is you can stay from anywhere in the world. All you need is an internet connection and a device to connect to the internet, and you can set up an online business and sell products to people all over the world. If you are not interested in setting up a business, but rather how to save some money during the festive season, here are some tips. Set a budget. Outline all the objects you wish to purchase and how much they will cost. Look out for discounts. Discounts are a great way to get more for your money. Keep track of what you are spending. It is so easy to lose track of what you're spending and overspend. So keep track of what you're spending and hold yourself accountable. I am Roberto Ellis, and that was Money Matters, sending it right back to the Lunchbox team.
All All right, so that was some good advice. It's now time to take a look at today's menu.
If you're still seeking tips to adjust to learning or teaching online, curious about how to make healthy smoothies that you'll enjoy, or you'd like to know what great innovations were developed in 2020, we've got the experts just for you.
And Aralna, after last week's chef, I'm looking forward to those smoothies.
I can't tell you how much I enjoyed that. I really can't.
Honestly, there are also shout outs from our friends across the world and amazing music to sing you into a great mood.
And Chanel, we can't afford to forget the features. You know, Kristen, what do you have lined up for us?
Well, in today's features, we'll have Try Me, where you will see me showing you two TikTok dances. We will also be learning holiday DIYs to spruce up your space. And finally, we will hear some of your plans for the season. We're going to a quick break, but stick around for some tips on how to improve your online experience.
Yourself up the employment ladder. Boost your confidence to start your own business. Visit apply.ncu.edu.jm for the upcoming semester for the best values-based education in Jamaica today. NCU, owned and operated by the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Jamaica, Bahamas, Cayman, and the Turks and Caicos Islands. Call 963-7157 or 963-7254.
Due to the COVID-19 crisis, 2020 has resulted in some amazing creations in science, technology, and climate change. Today we have Lenika Roden, the Technical Information Officer at the Scientific Research Council, joining us to tell us more. Welcome, Ms. Roden.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
Incredible. So we want to find out, why did you choose this career path?
Okay, so I love the sciences. I've always loved when it comes down to innovating, mixing chemicals, that's me. And so, of course, having done an undergraduate degree in marine biology, this would have been the most, the best path for me, especially since it is that it merges one of my passions, education. So at the Science and Technology, at the Scientific Research Council, I'm the Technical Information Officer in the Science and Technology Education Unit, where it is that we're responsible for popularizing science and technology across schools in Jamaica and in communities. And so I am very much passionate about that when it comes down to getting young people involved in science. And because I know too the benefits of participating in science, when once you're a science student, your critical thinking level, I think it is superior, not to bash the social sciences majors, but you know, even at UWE, once it is that a science student decides to do a course outside of faculty, they tend to do extremely well, even better than their classmates who would be the social sciences majors or even the law majors. And so as a scientist, you're trained to think a particular way, and I think it benefits you in across different sectors in any field at all you decide to venture in. So yeah, that's one of the reasons why I do what I do.
Thank you so much for that, Mrs. Roden. What are some of the innovative ways that the Scientific Research Council has promoted science, technology, and climate change?
Okay, thank you for that. So of course, you know, with COVID-19, the usual modus operandi where you would have been going into the different schools, participating in different external exhibits. that has been affected. And so at the Scientific Research Council, we have been able to pivot greatly in the sense that we've hosted several webinars, such as the hashtag Science Career Talk. We recently had an expo, Youth Regional Expo, themed the digital age youth participation. And we also have been having virtual training sessions. So for people who are interested in making soaps, lotions. So we have been able to pivot in the sense that the very same services that we would have offered in a face-to-face mode, we have been able to digitalize those. And we've also been having a lot of public consultations. So for example, our executive director, Dr. Cliff Riley, he has been participating in a number of webinars from the council.
Incredible. So we gather that there is a virtual event that is going to be staged by the Scientific Research Council. Could you kindly talk to us about that?
Oh, an upcoming event? Well, we have had events in the past. I can't speak to, I'm not sure if we have any coming up. I think we recently even ended a webinar series. I mean, you can see more of that on our Instagram page at src.jamaica. So we've had several, and also you can see the recordings on our YouTube channel, which is SRC Jamaica. So we've had several webinar events, or live events. So for example, the Digital Age Expo, the Youth Regional Expo, that expo was actually well attended. We had roughly 100 attendees, young people from across Jamaica, and we even featured an international speaker. We focused on areas such as cybersecurity, and specifically we had young people from the different universities, such as University of the West Indies and the University of Technology, highlighting their participation in science and technology, and also trying to ascertain from them as it regards to how is it that we can propel other young people to get involved in science and technology.
Wow, that's great stuff. What are some of the most successful and helpful scientific and climate change innovations that have been created in the year 2020?
Well, so that's an extensive list, actually. So when it comes on to climate innovation specifically, I feel as if young people have been championing the cause. And even recently with the Jamaica Nationals Water Project Challenge, they had a climate innovation competition. And in that competition, you would have seen young people creating and designing innovative technological solutions such as rainwater harvesting. And also one of the innovations that stood out to me was a system that can actually track your water usage. And you know, one of the impacts of climate change is that we are going to experience extensive droughts, and you know, with extensive drought comes a lack of water, and so we have to in a sense start using our water more responsibly and ensure that we're tracking the usage. And so, you know, young people have been coming up with different innovative solutions to solve these problems that we face, to solve the problems that we face. And so, you know, we want to commend the young people who have risen to the challenge. And, you know, one of the things I want to highlight is that there isn't enough support in that area for young people, especially as it regards to getting funding to do research and to develop a prototype for their innovative ideas. And so, you know, I want to call on all the universities, the private sector companies, and of course, other public sector agencies to see how it is that you can harness the potential that is out there, because young people have the solutions in their heads. They just need the support. They need a platform as to how it is that they can now bring their solutions to the forefront.
Incredible. Thank you so much for joining us, Ms. Roden. It was indeed our pleasure having you in the bag. Thank you so much. So at this time, we're going to turn over to Chrisanne, who is going to take us into our Big Seven feature.
Okay, thank you, Rana. So, across the seven continents, we have friends from all over the world. And for this feature, we will hear what they have to say. So check that out.
Hey guys, it's Mackay from London. Another windy grey day in the UK. Just to say a big shout out to the Lunch Bag crew.
Yo, what's up, man? This is Diego in Arizona. I want to give a shout out to the Lunch Bag Show and to all my homies in Jamaica. Keep it safe, be real. Remember, you can find beauty even in the nastiest deserts.
Yo, yo, Jay here from Canada. As you can see, I'm in Toronto right now. You know? Shout out Lunch Bag Crew.
What's good, everybody? It's Dante. I'm out here in New York. It's kind of cold, but big up all my Jamaicans, and most of all, big up Lunch Bag Crew.
Hey everyone, I'm Maria, and I'm from London. Just wanting to give a huge shout out to the Lunch Bag Show. Big up my Jamaicans.
Bonjour. So my name is Shamour, actually representing for the Lunch Bag Crew. So I'm here in France. I'm actually behind the Gros Horloge, okay, and that's currently in France. All right, so here we are.
Hey, what's up from Florida? It's loud as hell here. Shout out to Lunch Bag Crew. Shout out to all my Jamaicans. Let's get it.
Provoking, riveting, topical. On That Point is your monthly debate program that tackles the controversial issues in society. Watch as university debaters dissect topical issues plaguing our society in the British parliamentary format. You can't afford to miss out on the fiery discussions, bullet speed rebuttals, captivating and emotive arguments that aim to stimulate your brain cells and ignite your inner genius. Tune in to DCS YouTube channel and NCU TV every last Thursday of the month to view the Battle of the Intellects. On That Point is an initiative of the Department of Communication Studies in association with the NCU Media Group. On That Point will help you rediscover the genius you were born to be. DCS, developing talent, building a nation.
Team NCU FM, your education and wellness station. And while we are in this COVID quarantine lockdown, we must stay fit, especially as moms. I'm going to use my mop stick today to show you how we can remain fit even while we do our house chores. All right? So simple. Put the mop stick in front of you, and I'm sure you're going to turn your music on because we love that. And we're going to work right here, obliques. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you go for 8 and 8 on the other side. Another thing that we can do, just put it right behind us and do a fun move. Keep it fun. You go side to side, side to side. You can go down and up and keep a smile, down and up. This is your mop stick workout. Another move we can do, just roll it down behind you. Take a squat position, guys, and twist, twist, twist. Easy workout while you're doing your chores at home with your mop stick. And you go as long as you want and burst a sweat. Now, those are some tips that I use to keep fit at home. Stay tuned. NCU FM, your education and wellness station.
Hello? 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 Yeah, you. Hold on, and a pandemic, weena. You're not wearing a mask, you're not washing a hand, and you're not keep the required 6 feet distancing from other people. How could I really cause you? You need to stop it. That no mask, no wash, and no distance something there, nah keep. You know what keep? COVID-19. Yeah. It no gone nowhere. COVID-19, they are same way. So here why you I go do for all of we. Wear your mask, wash or sanitize your hands pan a regular, and yeah, keep your distance, please. And thanks.
I need to attend university, but there are so many choices. You know what I mean?
A place where I can get outstanding preparation for my life's work.
Come to Northern Caribbean University.
NCU builds character, creativity, and competence.
At Northern Caribbean University, you'll excel at your every educational goal.
NCU offers you a century of unparalleled educational excellence.
Superior in theology,
medical technology,
nursing,
topping communication awards,
information technology, dominating local and international technology competition.
Access over 70 degree programs.
Make the right decision.
I earned a Bachelor of Arts in Mass Communication at NCU. My training served as the launching pad for my work in the public and private sector as a television producer, presenter, writer, and mass communication teacher.
Northern Caribbean University, your superior educational choice.
Apply online at www.ncu.edu.jm. Call NCU at 963-725-027.
Welcome back. TikTok dances seem fun and pretty easy to do until you try them. I recently picked up a few TikTok moves myself. Check it out.
TikTok is one of the biggest social media platforms at the moment with 800 million users worldwide. This app basically allows anybody to post any or any little thing, including dancing. So today I will be busting a move and trying another thing. So my name is Kristen Hewitt and this is Try Me.
So the first dance move that we're gonna learn today is mode. And my producer insisted that I learn this over the weekend. Guys, I'm warning you from now, I'm not a dancer. So I'm gonna do my best and see what I can do. Okay, all right, so let's do this. After many attempts later, I think I finally got it. So let's see what I can do. Let's go. Okay. I didn't do too bad. I mean, when I did it by myself in private, I did pretty good. But now I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. Okay, so now we are going to do the surprise dance that my producer told me about. It's called Shower by Becky G. So let's do it.
Dances would you do like at a party or something?
I do the shower one. I'd love to do the shower one. The mood one, I need more practice on that. I know that we're all in quarantine and we know we're gonna actually become couch potatoes sooner or later. So let's use TikTok in a good way and learn a dance or two so we can actually improve our fitness as well. Okay, until next time, I am Kristen Hewitt and this is Try Me, okay? Bye!
Well, how did I do? Tag us on Instagram at DCS_NCU and let me know. What about you, Terry Kanchner? Would you try it?
Of course, you could have asked that.
Really? I see you do something like this one, you know, and I think I got it. Chanel, talk to me.
Honestly, when Chrisanne gets famous from TikTok, I hope she does not forget me. Now, joining us on set, we have Shanice Thompson, a mixologist at Rary's Pastries and Cafe. Hi, Shanice. Welcome
to the Lunchbox Show. So, Shanice, I'm going to jump right into the questions. Mm-hmm. What motivated you to become a mixologist?
I think it's the experience, or it's the me serving you.
Yes.
Because I don't only do natural juices. I actually went to school, alcohol and all that. To actually build something and give it to you from scratch and see like expression on your face, yeah. So that's priceless.
Basically, something that you loved.
Which is right.
Yes, and you wanted to pursue in something that what mm-hmm. you love.
Definitely.
All right, so what do you think is the secret ingredient, not just only the secret ingredient, what do you think the customers enjoy mostly about your drinks?
I'm not a copycat. You do have juices or punches or shakes that I might get ingredients from, you know, back in the days or okay. whatever, but I have my own touch.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? I make mm-hmm. it different, unique.
Now, what okay. I'm excited about is what will you be blending for us today? Because I see you have your ingredients mm-hmm. right
yes.
here. And they're making me excited. So tell us.
All right. So first, I am going to start with my famous avocado.
Mm-hmm. Good things for
smoothie.
The skin.
Yep.
Yes. All right. So.
I'm not a fan of avocado, but
you love this. Trust me.
Yes. Say no more.
I'm trying to have a question for her. What are the few ingredients that we can typically find at home to use to make a quick, healthy drink or a shake or a smoothie? What are the things we can use from home?
Just about anything that you have in... All right, who knew that an avocado could make?
Honestly, this is going to be my first time.
Okay. So just about anything fruity, vegetable that you have at home. I'd probably add a little ginger or, you know, ginger works with everything. Anything you have in your fridge, you don't need to go out and get anything.
Why do you want to do? Just talk us through what you're doing.
All right, so that's the avocado in there. I'm just gonna take a little milk.
Add in your milk.
Mm-hmm. You can use soy milk. You know, some persons
so it
are.
What
yeah, it doesn't matter. Milk. Right.
Okay. So while you're at that, how can customers reach you or get in contact with you?
Okay, so we're located 93 Manchester Road. And telephone number 962-3560. There's also a branch in Malgali, right?
Okay, understood.
Right. So you told us that you have avocado.
Yes.
And you have milk.
All right, so I put a little bit of vanilla.
What's that?
Vanilla Lasco in it. Most persons prefer condensed milk.
Your touch.
Yes.
This is your touch.
Yes,
this
is my touch.
Your touch.
All right.
So everything that's in here now, we have milk, we have
yes,
avocado,
and
we have...
Right.
Lasco.
I'm going to add ice to it, but I like to blend them first.
Sure,
no,
You're the pro now. We're just here talk with you and basically get a taste of what you... Because I'm looking forward to this.
The transition.
I am looking forward to this because I am not a fan of avocado.
Peer?
No, I'm not. But
can I have your
ice? No.
All right.
You don't necessarily have to add the ice, but it's better cool. Because, mm-hmm. Most persons don't like.
Do you see the transition from all of it? It was really.
Yes.
And then it's just.
You know?
Yeah.
You know, I really enjoyed it. You know, I really enjoyed seeing what you do. I'm really looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to that.
Mm-hmm. I'm an avocado fan.
Yes.
It's good for the skin, it's good for the hair, it's good for.
Just talk us through the process. What next will you be doing?
That's it. It's real simple. Yeah,
and you normally do this for your customers?
Yep.
It's requested.
It is requested because I started to introduce it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And from time to time, I have persons coming. You see that?
Yes, I see.
Yeah, real smooth. Right.
I'm guessing this one is
nice. Yes.
Or you can put it to my side.
Let me get
you
a straw.
Seeing that I'm not
Thank
a fan
you.
Of avocado, I see you have a lot more fruit and thing here.
Yeah.
You're going to make something for me?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. Wonderful.
All right, I see you. I'll try my avocado.
So,
right,
Seeing that you don't have another blender.
That's fine.
Maybe you can just talk us through the process.
Alright, so what I also was gonna do a blended fruit punch. Any fruits in it? Yes. Right. Watermelon, banana.
You're missing out. I'm sorry, I had to say it. You are missing out on the avocado.
Would you like?
Of course, I would like to taste it.
This?
The taste,
yes,
because I'm not a fan of this,
trust me,
but
I'm
have to taste it.
I'm tasting the last one. Yes. I'm tasting the avocado, and I feel like it's not even sweet. As she said, she wasn't using it for it to be sweet because she's on the healthy side.
Okay.
So you're tasting a little, it's kind of like honey. It doesn't even taste like sugar, even though honey is, you know, sweet. But I mean,
but it's much.
All right, so yes,
it's a tarry.
I'm getting that creamy flavor.
I'm gonna make your avocado.
You know, I'm tasting the pear. Mm-hmm. I'm tasting the vanilla lasco. Mm-hmm. Really getting that cool flavor that, from the ice.
So you're loving the avocado?
Yes,
wow,
yes, yeah, you know. Yeah, maybe.
She transformed your vision. Oh Lord.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. But I really want you to make something else for me.
Yes.
So maybe I can wash out.
I want to see the rest of things that are happening here. So by goes the avocado, and what are we looking at after?
All right, so I am going to do a pumpkin
punch. Pumpkin punch. Wow. Ah.
Pumpkin is your thing?
That's my thing now.
All right. You,
okay, you know, you have to chunk at the back.
Yes.
Great. All right, the pumpkin thing.
Yes.
I'm not a fan of pumpkin, but because she changed you from being not a lover of avocado to a lover of avocado, I'm pretty sure she can do the same thing for me with pumpkin. So let's see how it goes. I'm really interested in finding out what we'll be using the pumpkin for.
Yes, so just walk us through what you're going to do with
pumpkin. Mm-hmm. It's pre-cooked.
Okay.
All right.
So it has to be cooked.
It does not have to.
You don't have to be cooked.
We can just use it raw.
You can.
All right.
Wonderful.
I'm taking notes in the diary because we've been inside a lot.
Yes,
so you need to know what to do.
I've been feeling a little back pain from the other day, you know.
And also,
so the pumpkin is good for the back.
You can use the seed and everything. You don't have to like separate, and it's good to use the juice from the pumpkin.
So you're keeping the seeds in,
right?
All right. Because you know some
well
persons
strong.
Like to take the seeds out, but
you don't
you know,
have to.
But
that's a choice.
All right, cool.
Yeah, so
I'll be sipping in the meantime. She's yes.
All right.
So while she's doing that quickly, because we're winding down.
So we're adding milk again.
Yes.
Then,
just a little bit because we did use the water from the pumpkin.
Understood.
Okay.
Understood. So you're not going to use as much as you did with the avocado.
Okay.
And the reason I use milk is you can use your favorite stock that way. So your malta, your Guinness,
okay.
I think Terry just takes the malta and
definitely, definitely.
Just a little vanilla for flavor.
Okay.
Did we add vanilla to?
No.
We
so
add
that's new.
Yes.
All right.
And a little cinnamon. That's okay.
Cinnamon.
Yes.
Well, strong. Back is on the back.
Definitely ice because we did not freeze our pumpkin. So
right.
The ice is to cool it down. Right.
Yes, definitely. So she's adding.
And it's better not to do the pumpkin overnight for it to freeze because it kind of loses a lot of juice.
So even when we do make it, can we just put it on the fridge and then it'll be fine?
Yes. Yes.
Or just have everything one
yes,
time?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, we can do that. The more ice for this one, the better.
Because you need to keep it warm.
Ooh,
sorry.
Not
cool.
Warm. Yes.
The pumpkin would have been warm
yes,
coming out of the fact
cooked.
That it was
yes.
cooked.
All right.
So you need
I am
to keep
going
it cool.
to add a little bit of vanilla to this one, but for persons that do use their own stout at home, you don't need any sweetness because that stout already
it's
has
already, it. It's already sweet.
All right.
So it's already flavored, so you just add it for it. Just in case.
Yes, it is.
All right.
And I'm really looking
forward
to this.
We're blending now.
One.
All right. Almost
there. Chanel.
Huh?
You got a green juice. I'm really looking forward to it.
Another thing also I would suggest when you're doing the pumpkin punch, if you're going to keep the seeds in, it's better to use probably like a bullet so that you get the seeds real grind out.
Okay.
The blender.
And you don't necessarily need to keep the seeds. You can
no, you can take
them.
Alright.
Yes. Chanel just...
I'm loving the equality though, orange and green. Do I see that? I saw that where you're going with that.
All right, all right, all right. You know, I don't have a straw in it, but I'll just taste it from the glass.
Yes, that's fine.
All right. So this is mine?
Yes.
All right. Well, I don't want to leave the avocado. One of these tastes different.
Well.
What's going on?
Yeah, you know, I'm getting that. I'm tasting the seeds. Mm-hmm. As you said, it's definitely best to use the
I'm finding it hard to decide which one is my favorite. Let me taste it.
You know?
I think I'm sticking with the avocado.
Yeah?
I love the pumpkin, but I'm not the pumpkin person.
Okay.
So it's avocado for me.
And for me, you know, I'm not an avocado fan. However, I will
chose avocado. Sorry, no, you know.
They have changed my mind.
You're on my side, you know? Understood.
Yeah, so thank you so much for stopping by, Ms. Thompson. And we are looking forward to you basically going out there and doing your thing with other customers and sharing your expertise with others.
Right. Being the great
thank you for having me.
Is that you are continuing doing great things. And it was a pleasure having you today in the bag.
Right. We're going to take a break, but don't go away. You don't want to miss some interesting holiday time.
Destiny at NCU, champions of the annual National Business Model Competition since its inception. Gain valuable work experience. Move yourself up the employment ladder. Boost your confidence to start your own business. Visit apply.ncu.edu.jm for the upcoming semester for the best values-based education in Jamaica today. NCU, owned and operated by the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Jamaica, Bahamas, Cayman, and the Turks and Caicos Islands. Call 963-7157 or 963-7254.
Hello? 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 Yeah, you. Hold on, and a pandemic, we na. You're not wearing a mask, you're not washing your hand, and you're not keep the required 6 feet distancing from other people. And what could I really cause you? You need to stop it. That no mask, no wash, and no distance, something there, nah, keep. You know what, keep? COVID-19. Yeah, it no gone nowhere. COVID-19, they are same way. So here why you are gonna do for all of it. Wear your mask, wash or sanitize your hands pan a regular, and yeah, keep your distance, please.
I need to attend university, but there are so many choices. You know what I mean?
A place where I can get outstanding preparation for my life's work.
Come to Northern Caribbean University.
NCU builds character, creativity, and competence.
At Northern Caribbean University, you'll excel at your every educational goal.
NCU offers you a century of unparalleled educational excellence.
Superior in theology,
medical technology, nursing,
copping, communication awards, information technology, dominating local and international technology competition.
Access over 70 degree programs.
Make the right decision.
I earned a Bachelor of Arts in Mass Communication at NCU. My training served as the launching pad for my work in the public and private sector as a television producer, presenter, writer, and mass communication teacher.
Northern Caribbean University, your superior educational choice.
Apply online at www.ncu.edu.jm. Call NCU at 963-7250-7.
Some money and still have the things you need? All it takes is a little time and creativity. Take a look at these holiday DIYs.
Happy holidays, everyone. Today I will be showing you how to create 3 holiday decorations using simple things from around your house. Let's get started. First, you're going to make a wreath. You'll need pine cones, a bow, your glue gun, some Ponal glue, and you're going to need a circle shaped like a donut. I'm using black cardboard, and you're going to sandwich the two together and leave it to dry. You're going to paint your pine cones whatever color you like. We're using white, yellow,
and red. Be creative. Once the cardboard is dry, you're going to assemble your pine cones. Use some black paint to cover up any imperfections. You're going to add whatever bow of choice you like. Then you're going to get something to hang it up. And that's it. Now we're going to make a clock. You're going to need to cut out two circles. One of them you're going to cut out into strips. You're going to need gems, your clock pieces, a bow, and we decided to use an old clock frame. That's optional. You're going to now assemble your pieces together. Once it's dried, pierce a hole in the middle and paint it. We decided to paint it white to give it a rustic look. Now it's time to put the pieces together. So I used some dried lemongrass stalks and painted it and used it to decorate a vase. I loved how these turned out. Just look at them. I hope you'll try these to decorate your home this holiday. Happy holidays! Bye!
Welcome back. But, Rana. Okay, can I do that again?
Okay. Yes, welcome back.
All right.
Do not say
welcome. Exhausted. Sorry.
Welcome back. Rana, what do you have over there?
All right, guys. So that was an interesting video.
Right.
Yes.
Pretty much instructing us that we do not need to break the bank to spruce up our homes. But yes, what do you guys think?
Especially in the COVID time. So anything in and around your home can be used to make something.
Yeah.
And we're just proving that.
Yes.
In
yes.
the video.
For sure.
Also, what we've realized is a lot of persons are boosting their talents from home and putting it on social media now in the virtual
so
world,
true.
Which is something that's great. But guys, there's something I want to talk to you about.
Sure.
In a world where you can be anything that you want to be, choose to be kind. Mm-hmm. Now, I'll be speaking about Aspirar Jamaica Limited. Aspirar Jamaica Limited is a non-profitable organization that does in-reach and outreach projects all over Jamaica. They have three branches. That is a branch in Manchester, St. Elizabeth, and Kingston. I'm very fortunate to be the co-executive director for these amazing festivities. One of the things that we've done in this COVID-19 era is we've been to several different mm-hmm. And we try to limit or we try to ensure that we seek those persons that are super in need. We go to those homes and we give back. So we've conducted a food drive thus far. We've done a Feed the Street, which was very interesting because you'll tend to realize that in the streets of Mandeville, mm-hmm. there are a lot of persons who are homeless. Mm-hmm. So, you know, hunger, of course, is something that is
definitely.
Out of control in most situations. So we tend to look out for those persons that are really in need. And we have over 95 members in the organization, mostly persons that are students, university students, persons that are working, social workers, and we also have some counselors as well. And I'm talking about aging, well, the age range is from 18 to 32 currently, and it's just amazing. The president is Mr. Jerome Hansen. He is a student at the University of the West Indies, and of course, Chanel Mills, student at Northern Caribbean University.
I don't want to seem like it's an interview, but you know, what kind of motivated you guys to come up with this initiative?
The truth is, Tariq, when you look around this world, you'll realize that there are a lot of persons that need help. And if you are that person that can offer, go right ahead and do it. Once your heart is in the right place, yes, then you know for a fact that you just want to put smiles on faces and impact lives positively. Currently, we're having, our current initiative is a food drive because we're seeking to help persons in and out of Jamaica that are totally in need. So our information will be given out. And if you want to reach out to us, we are on Instagram at Aspera Jamaica Limited. Yes. So you can check us out on Instagram. Okay. And just reach out to us and we'll get back to you and, you know, help somebody to help somebody else so we can all help each other.
Definitely.
Love that. Yes. That sounds awesome. Each one, right?
That's it.
Incredible, incredible.
Yes.
So let's now go to a break, but please stay tuned for our plans for the season.
Provoking, riveting, topical. On That Point is your monthly debate program that tackles the controversial issues in society. Watch as university debaters dissect topical issues plaguing our society in the British parliamentary format. You can't afford to miss out on the fiery discussions, bullet speed rebuttals, captivating and emotive arguments that aim to stimulate your brain cells and ignite your inner genius. Tune in to DCS YouTube channel and NCU TV every last Thursday of the month to view the Battle of the Intellects. On That Point is an initiative of the Department of Communication Studies in association with the NCU Media Group. On That Point will help you rediscover the genius you were born to be. DCS, developing talent, building a nation.
Welcome back. The holidays are known for being a time of togetherness. For some, family and friends bond, whilst for others, it's a time for adventure or just merely another day. Check out some of the plans that some people have for the season.
My COVID plans for this upcoming holiday season would more than likely be to stay on dorm and hopefully purchase a PlayStation 5 and a couple of games and just games for the 1 week that we get off from school and probably do a bit of preparation for next semester.
I am definitely going home for the holidays. You see, I'm never broke, but I stay up here so I don't feel I just enjoy the candy, but brokenness, maybe I have to wear my home, do something to do, and some family fun. So
so my plans for the upcoming holiday, probably go home, spend time with family, eat good food, enjoy myself, or I might stay, I'm not sure as yet, but I might go home and finish my stay one day. So yeah, that's it.
Alright, so my plans for the holiday season, I wish to stay on dark. I don't really want to go home, to be honest. But if I have to go, I have to go home. Like, I'm mainly looking forward to the food, like at home. Because due to the COVID season, like the holiday season kind of messed up in a sense. So I actually wish to stay here, but if my friend is gone, I'm gone.
Alright, so my COVID plans. Probably like a week off school. Yeah, during that week, I'm gonna wake up real early, get a football, and practice shooting. And I'm gonna eat if the caps even open. And then go back to my room, sleep, prepare for next semester.
What I plan to do over the holiday in this COVID time, I just plan to relax with my family and just eat some food.
For the upcoming holiday, I'll be spending time with my family, I'll be cooking, and I'll be going out with my friends to socialize.
For this holiday season, I will be spending some much needed quality time with my family, sharing our holiday memories and eating a lot of food.
Big up the lunch bag crew.
Hey, let me say a million times more because the lunch bag crew in each ward, remember them there. We go to the self outside.
Whatever your plans are, please be safe, keep healthy, and have a wonderful time. Over to you, Ralna, Tariq, and Chanel.
As the show winds down, we want to leave you with a few seasonal celebration tips to help you and your loved ones remain closely knit despite being apart.
One tip, host a virtual holiday party. Usually holidays are times spent with family and friends, but this holiday season may be a little bit different. For the sake of difference, please be safe, everybody. But who says you can't have fun? Who says it has to end, guys? A virtual party is a great getaway for your family and your friends, so enjoy some quality time together.
That's true. And guys, I think we should take this into, into practice, because this is a way to continue spending time with your families, mm-hmm. however it is virtually. Mm-hmm. So you see, Michael, you talk on the phone, maybe you want to connect with somebody overseas, you call her on the phone and you include them
in
the
almost like it's happening
in the party
physically. Yes.
And you can just pause and pick up with part two the next day or whenever. It really doesn't have to end, as you said.
You know, one of those things that I've been seeing since this whole COVID era is a Zoom party.
Yes.
Zoom games,
yes.
Online games. And those yes. things are actually, despite the fact that we can't go outside, being on our phones and being there with our family members or people that we love, it's a whole vibe.
It is.
That yeah. is. Another tip is have a household holiday cook-off.
Mm-hmm.
One great thing about the holiday season is definitely food.
Oh, yeah.
So this year, you can still have a great time by doing a holiday cook-off. All you have to do is challenge the members of your household to see who can pull off some probably the best tasting meal.
Yeah.
Put each other to the test. You understand, guys?
Yes.
So maybe you know like you can't cook, but
that's the thing.
You know,
Tari,
probably
just,
if you do something,
trying to throw some shade. But another tip, guys: send virtual gifts. Many look forward to receiving gifts during the holiday season. I know I do, guys. So you
yes.
should be looking into
yes.
that. You can still keep up with the tradition with a virtual twist.
By wire transfer.
Yes, makes a lot of sense.
All right, yes. I am all about that idea, of course. So ebooks, product subscriptions or memberships and gift cards are just the tip of the iceberg for what you can do this year. What do you think about in terms of gifts for the season, Chrisanne?
I completely agree. You won't have to worry about picking up the gifts nor joining any lines. You simply stay at home and place your order at your own convenience. Right, Derek?
That is definitely right, Chrisanne. So, guys, this has been another great show in the bag. This has definitely been another great show in the bag.
Tari, can you believe we've come to the last episode of season one for the lunch bag? Am I the only one getting a little bit emotional?
No, you're not.
Okay, all right. I thought it was just me.
But guys, I really enjoyed every bit of the production that we had.
Yes.
From the get-go, I enjoyed the starting of the show. I enjoyed the montage.
Yes.
You know, I enjoyed
something
the music,
to rock to.
Definitely.
Yes, definitely.
And the most memorable moment for me is the fact that I was able to you remember the interview that I did with the beard guy?
Yeah.
And they gave us the tips on how to groom our beards.
You've been taking some advice.
You know.
You look at that, because even last week's show that I had with the chef, I went to him and I tried some of that because I've never had tofu before the show.
Oh.
So that was something that was interesting. Overall, though, guys, something that I will miss about the show is you guys.
Okay. I will miss
yes.
the crew. You know, big up our crew.
Definitely.
Our hardworking production team. Mm-hmm. Big up you guys, you know. And big up us as hosts. Big up yourself, Chrisanne.
All right.
What about you, Rana?
Just what the finished product is going to be like. You know, when we get here for the show, we have no idea what's going to happen.
Yes.
And then we go through, we do what we have to do, and the show is finished, and we're feeling good about it. So just to see what we can do together. I'm going to miss that for now.
Definitely. So, yeah. Crystal, tell us, what will you miss?
Well, what I'm going to be missing, I'm going to miss the features. I love the features so much because the features just show us a tube of the creativity that we have bubbling up inside of us. I'm going to miss the features. I'm going to miss you guys the most.
But guys, over.
All right.
I am really looking forward for our last tip from the tip jar.
Let's get right to it.
You just said last.
Yes.
This is a very important message from our sponsors.
Yes.
From our organizers.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And from our best friends wherever they are.
That's it.
So, stay close to anything that makes you glad you are alive.
That's right.
Stay close to anything, I'm going to go ahead and say, or anyone.
Yes.
Who makes you glad you are.
And that's just the right note to close the show.
I definitely agree.
Of course. So thank you for joining us for the first season of Lunchbag. You can follow us on Instagram at DCS_NCU and on the Facebook at DCS, Department of Communication Studies, to see what it's like behind the scenes.
All right, so guys, let us know what was... Well, which of the tips you will be trying for the season, you know, let us know by commenting on the YouTube page, commenting, leaving us, at, or probably tagging us in some pics of you doing stuff for the season.
And we'd love to hear about what you liked about the show as well, guys.
Awesome. So, enjoy the music, stay blessed, stay safe,
see you next
and stay in the bag.